As the Kingdom of Swaziland celebrates its 48th Independence Day, Swazi TV had the honor of interviewing His Excellency the Prime Minister Dr. Barnabas Sibusiso Dlamini to find out what the date of the 6th of September means to the Swazi nation. The Prime Minister says the 6th of September is an important date in the calendar of the country. When you look that their majesties were ruling the country, but due to situations back then, they felt that they should be assisted by the British. The Prime Minister says they were grateful that the British assisted the country when there were wars and in all aspects of the kingdom. He says they are also grateful that when their majesties and the entire Swazi nation asked for their independence, it was easy. The British handed over power without any resistance because Swazis engaged in a dialogue with them. His Majesty sent delegations to England and they reached an agreement.
Maswati akhulumisana nemangisi ingwenyama yawathumele mabandla eNgilandi wakhuluma nalabo bakhona la kangwane mangisi kwavunyelwana kuthi sale wehla umjeka wemangisi ukhuphuka weMaswati sale ingosi yeMaswati ingwenyama sale ibangulo nguye umholi welive mangisi ke sataba nje tihlobo tengwenyama sataba basiti belive kodwa ke hayi baholi belive kungakho ke September 6 abaluleke ngalokho.
The Prime Minister says Swazis were going to celebrate even more back in 1968 had they known that 48 years later, after attaining its independence, the Kingdom of Swaziland would be as developed as it is now. Dlamini says the development that has taken place over the years since independence is visible to everyone. When you look at the road infrastructure, health facilities, schools, and many things, including the social welfare of Swazis, it shows that it was indeed time for Swazis to be independent and be led by His Majesty as per the Swazi culture, have its own parliament, courts, and everything that makes a nation. He says the pace at which the development has taken place in the country is highly appreciated. And one example is that back then, only a few Swazis owned cars, property, and land. But in this day and age, it is no longer the case, which is an indication that the country attained its independence. Going forward, the Prime Minister says it is everyone's wish that the country continues to develop as it moves towards attaining first world status by 2022.
Nelive ngoba live lenyende kangwane bella bekunene bekuhamba kodwa kenyalo nelive nje ukhanza ukuthi mafarm seMaswati noma yini ma title deeds saphethwe ngeMaswati. Kunyandike lesingakubala le kube besathi nga 1968 injabulo beyaba inkulu kakhulu mayelana nekuthi livele yabe lithuthuke libhekebe konke ke lokho sibonga wona emakhosi lahola live sibonga emaswati kubambisana nawo emakhosi sasethemba ukuthi asike fike ekugcineni ngoba naye ingwenyama ikhuluma nga 2022 lesive sonke sivuma lapho ukuthi 2022 akube nemehluko lomkhulu sive sibe nemandi sive sibe nagezi sive sibe nekudla kuswela kunciphe kangwane ngiloko ke uhulumende wembube lasebentetu kwako ukuthi nasifika ku 2022 lethi ngingathi beti inciphile kakhulu dingimngado ukuthi wonke umuntu abe nemandi lenele lahlobile kukhanye emakhaya kube nagezi kube nekudla maswati abe ngilafunzile ngoba kuyasita nakufunza nawufunzile kunyenda lokuvuleka ko engqondweni ngakho ke silapho nyalo bekunene kusukulumende wembube uphokophele ekutheni 2022 kube nalomunye umehluko lomkhulu evene njengoba sibona umehluko lomkhulu nasibuke mva nga 1968 sibongela ke wona emakhosi ngoba sithi 48 nje sisho live sisho yona ingwenyama so naye wekunene siyamthumisela simfisela lunwele loluthe kanye ke nenina wesive indlovukazi naye wekunene simfisela lunwele loluthe nempilo lenhle futhi ke lenze.
The Prime Minister ended by saying that it is everyone's prayer that the Almighty God continues to bless the Kingdom of Swaziland, preserve its stability, and it continues to develop. Reporting for Swazi TV News, I'm Sibusiso Dlamini.